My name is JP Gervais, and I am the Chief Agricultural Economist at Farm Credit Canada. My role is to provide economic analysis to help our customers understand the drivers of agri-food markets, as well as to drive good business strategy at FCC. The agri-food industry is a very important component of the Canadian economy, employing more than 280,000 people in 2013 and contributing 1.7% to Canadian gross domestic product. It is also a very resilient industry. During the 2008 and 2009 recession, food manufacturing GDP actually increased while other manufacturing sectors declined. While it is resilient, there are also some challenges in some sectors. In 2013, Canada's secondary food processing sector ran a large trade deficit of about $6.8 billion. To put things in perspective, the deficit was less than $1 billion 10 years ago. Because of the importance of the sector, it is critical to think about the drivers behind this trend. Trade flows with the US explain a lot of the trend. Over the last 10 years, over 84% of all secondary food processing exports went south of the border. This percentage is lower if we capture all primary and secondary food processing. In that case, exports to the US made up over 65% of overall agri-food exports. The value of our food imports from the US grew in 9 of the last 10 years, sometimes in excess of 10% a year. Canadian food exports increased between 2004 and 2013, but the pace of the increase did not match the pace of increase in the value of imports from the US. The value of the Canadian dollar relative to the US dollar is certainly one of the factors behind the trend. But other issues, such as productivity differences between the two countries, are also factors to consider. Canada is facing a large deficit in an important manufacturing sector. Clearly, there's a need to find ways to remain competitive. There are some bright spots, however. Despite a higher dollar environment and the financial crisis that hit markets in 2009, Canadian food processors still managed to grow overall exports by 30% since then. Export to markets other than the US are also growing, and in 2012 and 2013, Canada's total exports of secondary food processing have grown faster than our imports. A trade deal with the European Union and other initiatives to open up foreign markets will help competitiveness. Innovation and product differentiation appear promising strategies in a world where consumers increasingly demand high value and sophisticated food products. Canadian food processors can certainly deliver. Every level of the supply chain wins from a strong food processing sector.